friends, welcome to my channel, My Academic Point. So, now Navratri is going on. So, all are enjoying and sleeping in daytime, but I will disturb you. You can watch it anytime, no issue. Watch the full videos to understand this. Till now, I had explained you about the tenses of simple, continuous and perfect. Now only one more is left, perfect continuous. But before that I taught you, let me teach you about the time clause, if clause, for and since. For and since I already have taught you when we use for and when we use since in the prepositions one videos. Okay, you can see that videos. And today I am going to explain you these time clause, if clause and for since. So friends, be ready with your pen and notes. Whenever we are writing our, we are making our own notes, na, that is only we will keep in our mind. Okay, so please be ready with that notes. And this video is not only useful for the students, but academic wise, but it is also useful for the competitive exams. Okay, so we have learned a clause also. What is a clause? Clause is a sentence that is a bigger part of a, that is a part of a bigger sentence. It has a subject and a verb of its own. Okay, a clause means a bigger part of the sentence is, subject is also there and a verb is also in that. But today I am going to teach you what is time clause. Time clause means that mentions the time of an actions. With the actions, the time will mention, that is the time clause. Okay, for the time clause begins with the linking verbs. Time clause begins with the linking verbs before, if, until. Before, if, until, like this, until, after, while, since, when, as soon as. This all which goes for the time of an actions. Okay, remember that we never use future tense in the time clause. We never use the future tense. Okay, this tense will never use because in the time clause. In the time clause, we use only the simple present. Simple present means, what is the formula for the simple present? Who will say? V1 plus S or ES. And even in the main clause is in the simple future. The time clause has two types. First part is the main clause. And second part is the time clause. Okay, in the main clause we will use the simple future. What is the formula for the simple future? Who will say? Anybody ready for that? Will or shall plus V1. Will or shall plus V1. That is the simple futures. Okay, so this I had explained you that the simple present, the formula will be V1, S or ES. Simple future, the formula will be shall or will plus V1. Okay. So now let me see the study the sentences. The crops will die before the rains fall. The crops will die before the rain, what the sentence, before the rains fall. Okay, here see, the crops will die, this is the main clause. The main clause it is, and before the rains fall, that is the time clause, because here before is coming, the linking verbs. Okay, I have explained it that the linking verb before, if, until, till, after, while, when, as soon as, this all the verbs, linking verbs comes, that time the sentence begins with the time clause and before that the main clause. I shall help him if he comes to me. I shall help him if he comes to me. So, okay, if we need any help, but we are not saying directly, we are saying indirectly, we are saying to other friends, that friends will inform, so that what you, I will help him, but he should come with me, he will come to me, then only I will help you. So here the if word is there, that is the time clause. Okay, begins the main clause, then the time clause. The third sentence I will orally explain that. We shall light the fire when it gets cold. The word when is coming, that is a time clause. So time clause means that mentions the time of an action. And the time clause begins with the word before, if, until, when, as soon as, after, while, till. These all the words will come, then the time clause. It like identify the time clause. Understood? So I had explained you the if clause, main clause and the time clause. Now I am going to explain you about the if clause. What do you mean by if clause? So if clause is the simple way, just we have to see some following notes only. It is the form of the verb. Okay. For time if clause, if the verb, just we have to see the rule, main clause and the if clause. See. Main clause and the if clause. In time clause I said when the times begins, the when the mentions the times of an action, the when the words begin, that sentence is the time clause. Now just in this if clause, when we will use the if clause, the main clause will be, if the main clause will be will plus v1, the if clause will be v1. Okay, understood this one? If the main clause will be would plus v1, the if clause will be v2. The would plus here, third one, would have plus v1 here v3, perfect one, then here had plus v3 we use. Again, I am explaining you the main clause and the if clause. In the main clause, if the word will in the sentence will plus v1 is there, present tense is there, then if clause the present tense will only come. If in the main clause would plus v1 is coming, would, so in if clause the past tense will be there. When the main clause the word have, would have plus perfect, so that time V3, so that time we will use the had plus V3 in the if clause. Okay, so with the few example I will explain you. So how to frame the sentences, then only you will get it. These 3 points. The first one is, the first sentence, if he comes, I shall help him. Then if he came, I would help him. If he had come, I would have helped him. See, in this the sentence begins with the, what the sentence begins with the if. Here first if is there. Okay, when the if is there, the first sentence here v1 is there. What is that? V1 plus else. Okay, so here we will use will or shall in future tense, will or shall plus v1. Okay, got the point? Now in the second sentence, if he came, I would help him. If he came, here v2 is there. So here what is that? Would plus v1. Understood? Help is v1. Okay. And if the third sentence, if he had come, I would have helped him. So he had come. V3 is there. So, okay, HAD plus V3, sorry, here the formula is HAD plus V3. So, here see, would HAD plus V3 is given. See the simple sense. With that three words only, will plus V1 we will use in if clause, would plus V1 in if clause, V2 past tense, would have plus V3 to be if clause, had plus V3. So this only we have to remember this point. Now I will give you the next example also, one more example I will, so that you will understand the when the if clause and the main clause are given. Okay. The sentence is, the next sentence will be, the horse will kick if you go near it. The horse would kick if you went near it. The third sentence, the horse would have kicked if you had gone near it. See, these three sentences I have given you. In that three sentences also it is showing that first one is the main clause, it is given because the if is used afterwards. So this is the sentence main clause. Okay, after if is given, that is the if clause. So in the main clause, the word will kick is there. So when the word will plus V1 is there, so see here only V1 is used after the if clause. Okay, after the if clause, V1 we use. And when it is a main clause in the second sentence, the horse would kick, that is a main clause. So if it's given, so here would plus V1 we had used. So here we go for the verb V2 after the if. Okay, when if clause is there. See, in this third sentence also, the main clause is, the horse would have kicked, that is the main clause, if you had gone near it. After if, the it is a if clause. So here in the third sentence, would have plus V3 we use. So here in the next sentence we had plus V3. See, with these two examples you come to know when we use the type clause, if clause. Okay, just it's a short rules only. Just we have to remember that the short rules of these things, then only we will come to know. Okay, so everybody understood what is the if clause and time clauses. I'd explain. Now I will explain you about the for and since. So please friends, watch the full videos, then only you will come to know. I will understand. For and since, both the verbs are the prepositions of time. For and since is used to both in prepositions. Okay, it is a prepositions of time. That answers the questions. They answer the question how long. Okay, for, what do you mean by for? It is a period of time. What is for? It is a period of time. And what do you mean by the since? It is the definite point of time. What is the since? It is a definite point of time. See, just for the example I say, Misha has lived here for 2 years. Okay, so I had explained, I want for this, I want for 15 minutes, I want since, I was working since January 94, like this. So period of time, when we use for the for and when we use for since, for example, if the for is there, so we will write for 15 minutes, okay, for half an hour, the example, for half an hour, for a month, for 3 years, for a month, for 3 years. These are the examples for when we use for. And when we use since, it's a definite point of time, means since Monday, since Tuesday, since January, since any month name we will say. Okay, and since Diwali. So these all the means the definite point of time. This I had explained you in the prepositions also. 2 to 3 videos are there for this foreign since. Please watch that video if to understand in the details. Okay. So foreign since also I had explained you. The main basic was when we use the foreign since, that is the foreign since verbs are also coming in the present. Perfect continuous tense. So I have used these foreign since I had explained in here. Time clause and if clause is the short portion, so I had explained that also when we use the time clause and the rules of the if clause. So friends, if you have any doubts or queries, any, then you can send me the message in the mail ID and the WhatsApp number. It is there in the descriptions. And so friends, you liked it? You understand everything, na? I think so that in this also I will not give you exercises homework, because I know nowadays you are having the Navratri, you are enjoying a full night and the daytime you are sleeping. So I will not give the exercise. Later on after the Navratri I will give you some work, so that Diwali vacation is there, so you can practice it that time the exercises. That time I will give you the work. Okay, so friends, if you like my video, then click the like button, comment, share, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon. And my next video will be about the perfect continuous tense. Thank you.